Welcome to our online English class. In today's class, we are going to learn about degrees of comparison. Before starting the class, I just wanted to share my shopping experience during Christmas holidays. On 25th of December, we went to a bakery. I thought to buy a white forest cake because it tastes good. But my son said, black forest cake is tastier than white forest cake. So we both are very confused, so we decided to ask the shopkeeper. We went and asked the shopkeeper which cake tastes good. The shopkeeper said, red velvet cake is the tastiest of all the other cakes. So finally, we bought a red velvet cake and came home. Here, did you listen carefully? We said about tasty, tastier and tastiest. The first one is taste good. So it's positive. I have said about one thing. But when two cakes are compared, it was said that's tastier. Black forest is tastier than white forest. Then the third time when the big shopkeeper, he said it was the tastiest. So today we are going to learn about these three degrees of comparison. Positive. Next one, comparative. And third one is superlative. So let's learn about this in detail. Shall we? Come on students, let's learn about this degrees of comparison in detail. Now I would like to give you one more example. One day, I decided to buy a small perfume. I asked my dad to buy a small perfume and he bought me this small perfume. But I asked little more smaller than this. So then I got this perfume which is really smaller than the first one. But I need little more smaller. So finally, I bought this perfume. Dear children, when I spoke about one thing, that is positive thing, it was said as small. But when I compared two things, it was said this is smaller than this perfume, right? Finally, when I spoke about the last one, that among more than two things is compared, it is said as smallest. Let's see some more examples, right?
Most adjectives form their comparative degree by adding ER and superlative degree by adding EST. Look here, small is an adjective and when it's used in a comparative form, we have added ER to the word small. Then when it is used as superlative degree, we have added EST. But if an adjective ends in Y with a consonant before it, change the Y to I before adding ER and EST. For example, two words are given here. Look, the first word, HAPPY. The word ends with a letter Y followed by a consonant letter P. So we have added for superlative degree IEST and comparative degree IER. Similarly, the next word LAZY, it ends with Y followed by the consonant letter Z. So here again, for comparative degree we have added IER and for superlative degree we have added IEST. Sometimes the last letter of the positive is doubled before adding ER and EST. Example, BIG is a positive degree. We have doubled the last letter GG and we have added ER for comparative degree and EST for superlative degree. Similarly, FAT is a positive. When we are changing it into comparative degree, we have doubled the letter T twice. All adjectives of more than two syllable form comparatives by adding more and superlative by adding most before the positive form. By the way, what is this syllable? Children, while we are pronouncing a word, small words, it will have single sound. For example, big. And see, this clever is a two-syllable word. And the third one is a word which has more than two syllable. Look here, beautiful. For such words, we have to use more before comparative degree and most before superlative degree. For example, wonderful. For comparative degree, we have to use more wonderful, and for superlative degree, we have to use most wonderful. Some adjectives have completely different forms for positive, comparative, and superlative degree. These are called irregular adjectives. Now, let's see few examples for this. Good, better, best. Bad, worse, worst. Many, more, most. Little, less, and least. Now, let's see examples how to convert a positive sentence into comparative and superlative degree. Come on. Nayan is a clever boy. In this sentence, clever is a positive degree. Farhan is cleverer than Nayan. Cleverer, this is a comparative degree. Last one, Raju is the cleverest boy. Cleverest is a superlative degree.
I'm sure you all got better understanding about this degrees of comparison. So now it's time to wind up this class. I'll meet you all in my next class. Until then, it's bye from me.